Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, welcome back to another video. And today I'm pretty excited because this is actually my first ever bookshelf tour on my channel. So like most people, I do very much enjoy buying books, not only to just read them, but personally I actually really like them as like decoration. The right cover, the right aesthetic, just the right placement in a house can make them look really good. I'm a pretty big fan of like decorations and like knickknacks and stuff like that. So you'll kind of see that in a lot of my bookshelves as well. And no, I did say bookshelves because yeah, I have a lot of different places where I put my books. I was actually very fortunate this year to not only of course be able to have the funds to purchase multiple bookshelves, but I also got pretty lucky with some sales, and I think like one that my sister wasn't using anymore, so I obtained a lot of bookshelves in 2020. Most of these are a lot more condensed than they used to be. At my last house, I really had books in like a lot of different places, like end tables and things like that. So I think with all the bookshelves I collected this year, I really have not enough books to fill them all, so most of these are pretty condensed. But enough of the intro, let's just kind of get right into it. I am sort of separating these by rooms and in sort of like before and after videos. So this first video shows my manga shelf. So this is actually in my bedroom where we actually have a spare TV, and this is just where like my PS4 is sitting, and this is kind of like my manga are kind of halfway there. You're supposed to see it where I sort of have my manga sort of like split. I don't have a ton of them, or at least I didn't for a while, so kind of having them on the same shelf or having a whole bookcase for them wasn't really that viable. So this is the before picture. You can kind of just see that there were like some manga stuff at the very bottom. I actually have a lot of like my mass market paperbacks and like some more Star Wars, sort of like an overflow Star Wars shelf, as you'll see. And of course you'll see, making many cameos during this video, is my fluffy dog Nova. He's so precious. He definitely wanted to get in a lot of the shots, even though he kind of looks like he's like doesn't want to be filmed. He can't help but getting in the way. So now you'll see the after video. The bottom of the shelf is mostly still the same. It's just got a lot of Star Wars books and some like overflow mass market paperbacks, as well as some Star Wars knickknacks. The shelf above it, I organized a bit more, and I actually added more manga to it. So you'll see, like I said, I didn't really have that many, but I did add the Vinland Saga books that were once on another bookshelf and kind of like sorted the pops a bit. And then on the PS4 shelf, I just again kind of moved around some of the pops. So I think this looks a lot better. Like obviously it's not a very big shelf, but I think it looks a lot more organized and more complete than it did before. This next shelf is actually on the opposite wall of the one before, still in my bedroom. Again, this is definitely a pretty big like overflow of more knickknacks and sort of decorations. I don't really have too many books on this one. You'll see on the top shelf I sort of had some, I have a lot of art books. I actually am a really big fan. I think I talked about this in like my massive like 2020 book haul, is that I definitely really like buying art books, especially from video games. That's one of the main reasons why I really love video games, is the artists that do all the concepts and the scenery. Like, it's just incredible work. It's just like, you don't really think about it because the whole point of a game is to play the game and the graphics and the story and all that stuff, but the art is usually so amazing. And the topmost shelf you'll see is really just for, I didn't know what to do with this, but this is sort of just book covers that I really like. And you'll see this on a later shelf where I sort of just have them turned sideways so you can sort of see the spine and the cover. And these are kind of just like my biggest, sort of like the cooler looking books. I decided to actually go ahead and split it to run the left side where the books that I have read, and the right side are books that I have not read. There's also like a whole shelf for like a ton of Harry Potter memorabilia, and then Kingdom Hearts pops, and then just like my entire like DVD collection. So again, like I said, not really too many books, but there are some books in there and some book related stuff. So for some reason I actually skipped the after image of this one first. I must have did this out of order, but this is actually just quickly the drawing desk in my kitchen. I used to use a drawing desk, but since I don't really do physical artwork anymore, I don't really have any use for it. It used to be my office, but now it's just sort of like in the kitchen. And I really like this. If you don't know, this is actually artwork from on the left. That is Shallan and Kaladin, my favorite couple from the Stormlight Archives. And then on the right is actually a painting of the main characters from Red, White, and Royal Blue. So I don't know why, I just kind of, this is kind of book related, and I really like the way this kind of looks. It looks really nice just sitting there all neatly with the artwork. Then this is my comic book shelf. So this has obviously a lot of DC and Marvel stuff. You'll see the comic books at the top, and then mostly it's like pop memorabilia, and at the bottom is like novels based off of the comics. And of course there's Nova just coming by and saying hello. And this is the after shot, so you'll see that I added more novelization to it. So this is just stuff like my Black Widow books, X-Men, Avengers. Again, most of the stuff is definitely more for decoration than actual reading, but I have read a couple of them already. And then I sort of made the pop shelf all Avengers themed with all my DVDs and stuff like that. And then I think this top shelf, it looks a lot more full, especially since this has all of the stuff I think bleed from Christmas. So I think it looks really packed and nice. And yeah, it's just a really cool wall in my house that I really enjoy. It's like in our living room, so it's very prominent. And then just over here is just some more decorations I like to show off. I've got some Game of Thrones stuff. This is the before shot of my partner Andrew's desk, and then the bookshelf right next to it. So this book, I didn't really know, this is probably my newest bookshelf, so it has a lot of different stuff. I really like this idea of having two like sort of towering piles of books, and I just want some stuff in the middle. I obviously really like phoenixes, so there is a giant display of a phoenix, as well as Kitty Pryde, one of my favorite X-Men, and the Scarlet Witch from the Avengers movie, who's one of my favorite characters as well. So on the left side, we have like two sort of massive series. It's like all of my Dragon Age books and the legacy of, I can't remember, but it's the I Am Number 4 book series. I ended up buying the whole box set. I've only read the first one. It wasn't bad, but I really don't have a ton of interest in returning to it, so I don't know. And on the right side there has it actually has a series that I talked about. I believe in my like plans for 2021, it has the Novice series, or I think it's called the Summoner like trilogy. And then above them, the top right, it's like a series based off of Nicholas Flamel. And I think I got about 3 books in so far. And I don't know, it's okay. I read the first two when I was a lot younger, and so I thought I'd try rereading them and actually finishing the series. I just haven't really been inspired to finish it. But they're kind of just like two massive series I think could really fill this giant shelf. And then right below that, you can see a big Star Wars. This is sort of like my D&D shelf. Since me and my partner would play a lot of D&D, Star Wars, which is Force and Destiny, and Dungeons and Dragons. So these are kind of like all the books that we sort of want, alongside some figurines and such. And then beneath that is obviously a lot of empty shelves, which we will fill in later. Oh, and look, it's later with my complete shelf. So I decided at the bottom shelf, I still don't have anything really there for it. It might be like overflow at some point. And I want to have like a whole shelf dedicated to Book of the Month, which I just started in 2020. So this is my Book of the Month shelf. Right now I've only got about 3 of them, and then I think I have 2 more coming for January because I accidentally skipped December. And this bookshelf right here, you will definitely recognize if you watch again my 2021 plans. This is sort of like my immediate TBR shelf. This just has all the books that I want to read as soon as possible. So some of these are definitely the ones for January. Actually, I don't think January is in here. Yeah, we'll get to that later, but yeah, these are just the books I want to pick up like as soon as I can. Now, I think the rest of the shelves, I sort of just organized this one a bit more, made it look not so as cluttered, more organized. And this one, again, just looks the same. I just cleaned up some of the elements a bit. And this is my beautiful kitty, Sarabi. She is laying under my, I guess, like this really cool bookshelf that I got for, I think, my birthday. It's just this, it looks like, you know, a hero is carrying the books. And I just want to put like some of my favorite books. This is the Hunger Games series and the Captive Prince. So yeah, I know it kind of looks just lonely there in the middle of the wall, but there's only so many places I could put it. And this is the before shot of my office. This is where I normally do my recording videos and stuff like that. So this is technically like the library, the creative space. This is the before shot. This has all of the Brandon Sanderson books up top. And I love these bookends. They're like octopuses or octopi, whatever. I found them like once upon a time, put them on my Amazon wishlist forever. And I think last year my mother got me them for Christmas. And I just absolutely love them. I think they're so cute. I have this thing with octopi. I don't know. I think they're kind of interesting. So these are, anyways, as I said, the mostly entirely UK editions of the Mistborn first and second era. Most of the Stormlight Archives, and then Elantris, and I think that's Steelheart. The Stormlight Archives ones are a big pain because none of them are the right size or it's like some of them are just all together, like Wave of the Kings and Oathbringer, and later you'll see Rhythm of War. They are all single editions, but you also can buy them in two separate ones. For Words of Radiance, I couldn't find the singular combined edition, but even if I did, they might not even be the same size, because Oathbringer is definitely not the same size as Way of Kings. So yes, they're all aesthetically nice and pleasing to put together, but the shapes and sizes kind of throw it off. So this is definitely a big Harry Potter part of my shelf. I think this remains mostly unchanged. But yeah, top shelf is all of my, or the massive illustrated editions, which I think are really cool. The one below that has the really nice Ravenclaw edition of the books that they are still slowly coming out with. Below that is my Avatar The Last Airbender shelf. You'll have all of the like library editions of the comics, as well as clearly a lot of pops. And below that is even more Harry Potter pops, because I literally just can't stop buying them. And at the very bottom, I sort of just have these, again, more like overflow space for storage. Mostly, I usually don't like putting things on the very bottom of my shelf. One, because I don't 100% trust my dogs. For the most part, they're okay. But yeah, I usually just don't like putting anything down there. I usually never look at the bottom shelves, so I don't really pay attention to them. And this is the after shot. So you'll see my beautiful baby girl Mira on one spot. This is Nova. So again, this is still my office. This is my creative space. So I have like a really comfortable couch and chair that I can like read or lay on while I draw. And then the dogs love it too, because there's like the front window there. So they love chilling with me. This is my desk space right here. This is technically my monthly TBR. So pretty much all the books that I want to read for that month, I'm probably just gonna leave on my desk here. For like easy access, and like also keep, and then making sure to keep them there so I can do my review at like the end of the month or whatever. And so again, I have a lot more wall art, which I love. And then you'll see that a lot of the overflow Harry Potter pops made it over this way because I wanted to make space for more stuff. So now at the bottom of the shelf, you actually have the Avatar The Last Airbender shelf. I added a lot more of the library editions. I added more of the Avatar The Last Airbender ones, as well as Legend of Korra got her own too. So this looks a lot more stuffed, which I actually kind of like. If you do it nicely, sometimes like really stuffed shelves look really nice. And then here is my Sanderson shelf. I did lower it a bit because I just was getting tired of them like being shoved there on the top of the shelf. I was really worried about them falling off. So I ended up putting them right here in the middle. And then this is my Harry Potter shelf. Like I said, mostly, pretty much almost entirely identical. All those little candles are actually from Elliot Brooks's like massive like monster pack thing for her book Peace and Turmoil. And so she had like these scented candles for each one of her characters. I thought they were really cool. I think they all look nicely on the shelf together. And then at the very top, I still have my octopi, but I also have my like mini Fullmetal Alchemist shelf. I have all of the Full Metal editions here. I think they're really cool and they look really nice on the shelf there. And actually, even since recording this, the shelf has actually gotten a lot taller. I'll actually probably show you a picture because I got more editions after Christmas. And then my Ravenclaw blanket on the wall, and of course gotta say goodbye to my precious Mira. Now this is of course like the finale. This is like my actual bookshelves. They're right in the hallway as you walk into my house, and so there's like, it's where most of them are gonna be. So this is again the before picture, so you'll see some of the books that you've already seen, like the Fullmetal Alchemist editions, Vinland Saga. So these are already there. Again, this was also when I first, this actually had not really been organized since I moved into this house, because pretty much I moved in about around this time last year, about last February or so, and I sort of just threw a bunch of books on the shelves. Didn't really pay too much attention to where they were, so I don't really have any plan on like what these shelves are, except for like two or three exceptions, this being the first right here. And this is like my Percy Jackson shelf, or my Rick Riordan shelf really, because it's got the Egyptian books, it's got the Norse mythology books, pretty much all of them there. It also has the Stormrunner, which isn't a Rick Riordan book, but it's like one that his like publishing house published or something like that. And below that, again, you'll sort of just see like a bunch of mixture of books that are sort of just all over the place and disorganized. Oh, and look, hey, there's Mira again. And then this was, again, sort of the same thing I was doing with that shelf in my bedroom, where I sort of just had a bunch of nice books that I liked, like sort of facing sideways, just to sort of like cover more space, because I obviously don't have enough books to fill all of these. This shelf actually was like my 2020 bookshelf, so all the books that I had read or wanted to read were basically right here, so like were the easiest to see. This is like my main novelization of Star Wars shelf. I really like this shelf. The book, that big black book in the back, that's actually the artwork from the Jedi Fallen Order game, which I thought was really awesome, and the book is really cool. Like, these shelves right here below that are mostly my partner Andrew's shelf. He has a lot of books that are, he mostly deals with like big epic fantasy tales, so I kind of put all of his books sort of together. And at the very bottom, this is my unhaul shelf. So most of these are books that I plan on unhauling. But let's get to the final look of it. So this is my main bookshelf in the hallway. Of course, I had to get the fairy lights on and stuff like that. It's a staple for bookshelves. You'll see at the very top has a bunch of Lord of the Rings stuff. And now we come to the after part. So like I said, at the top of the shelf, I always like to make these sort of like the prettiest looking, because you usually your eyes are drawn to the top of the bookshelf. So most of these are just books I really like the cover, and I have them sort of like facing out. And again, since this is towards the top of the bookshelf, I have this shelf for being my mostly books that I really enjoyed or books that I want to plan on picking up right away after I'm sort of done with that immediate TBR shelf. So almost all these books are books that I have read and really enjoyed or are going to pick up like as soon as possible, really. The Percy Jackson shelf stayed the same. I don't really have much to say about that. This is sort of like my overflow fantasy section. These are mostly all books that are all based in fantasy, and there are like some sci-fi towards the right. This shelf is mostly, I would say, real world. So it's all stuff that's like based in our world. Some of it is just like straight contemporary. Most of the stuff on the left is like dystopian, like the Legend trilogy, the Maze Runner series, which I actually have not read. That those were my partner's books that I kind of like inherited. And again, some of these just to kind of fill space, I did forward face some of them. Some of the ones I either really liked, like Ali de Rue. I mean, the cover actually isn't that, and like the cover isn't anything crazy, but I actually still really like the way it looked. Plus I really liked the book. And then this is the bottom of the shelf. This is again more overflow contemporary novels or stuff set in our world. So it's kind of just like a mix and match of books like that. Going to the top of the shelf again, we have some more forward-facing books with covers I very much enjoy. I think half of these are actually I've read and haven't read. The one in the middle that's actually like with like a green edge and like a white cover, that's actually the Italian version of Peter Pan. And you'll actually see my Castlevania pops there. I love that show. Again, matching the shelf on the left, these are all books that I really enjoyed or plan on picking up sooner rather than later. Most of these I actually have read. Thanksy, looks like Skyward, Sorcery of Thorns, Wicked Fox, Strange Dreamer, Duology, Six of Crows, Kyoshi, Shadow of the Fox, The Diviners, Loch Lamora, Tiger's Daughter, Warbreaker. Yeah, I pretty much have read most of these. So yeah, this is just a shelf of books that I really enjoyed or plan on reading soon. This again is my Star Wars shelf, pretty much untouched. And then these are again overflow fantasy at the top, and then like epic fantasy ones that my partner really enjoys, and they're kind of just like the bigger books. And again, this bottom shelf is my complete, it's not mixed anymore. I think before I had Aragon and some other books on there, but this is my complete unhaul shelf. So most of these books are either books I didn't like or some of them I just need to get rid of. Like, unfortunately, my hardback edition of Rhythm of the War is there because my precious fluffy puppies, they destroyed the dust jacket, so that kind of sucks. So I'll have to be looking for a new one for that, so I can kind of just sell that at some point. But yeah, that is it. I think we got everything. The only thing I didn't show was the after image of what of that main bookshelf in my other room, but I don't think I changed much. I just sort of cleaned it up. The one that had all like the Harry Potter pops and the Kingdom Hearts pops on my DVDs, I think that one like most is the same. I just like cleaned it up a bit. But yeah, that is my full bookshelf tour. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what you liked about it. Let me know if you recognize any of the books, and if you saw any of them on my shelf that didn't look like they were on my immediate TBR, let me know you really liked them and I'll move those up. But yeah, I know usually these are sometimes fun. I definitely liked it as a nice refresh, a good way to start the 2021 year is to get all my books in order, make them look all nice and organized. Kind of just inspires you to get out there and start reading. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye now.